Hey, this is Seth from No Code MBA. In this video, we're going to talk about the differences and similarities between Webflow and Framer, and by the end of the video, you should have a good idea of which platform is right for you and your project. If you want to learn more about how to build with No Code, how to build your own websites, apps, and automations, go to nocode.mba and check out our full No Code education platform. So both Webflow and Framer are No Code website builders. Let's talk about the pricing first before getting into some of the other differences and similarities. So if we look at both pricing plans, both Webflow and Framer have free plans that you can use to try it out, start learning and building a basic site on a Framer domain or Webflow domain, meaning you can't add your own custom domain to either Webflow or Framer on their free plans. Framer is a little bit less expensive for a basic site. You can see it's only $5 a month for a site that doesn't have a CMS attached to it. And here a basic site is $14 a month when you're going to have a basic site with no CMS attached to it. A CMS is basically like a database that you're going to have to host data such as a blog or other dynamic pages or content that you want to show on your site. So Webflow is a little bit Webflow is a little more expensive than Framer. And then for a basic site that has one CMS collection, so a really basic blog, for example, you're getting up to $15 a month. That is a little bit more similar to the CMS plan, but that's really more of a basic CMS plan. And then the pro of $30 a month is going to be similar to Webflow's $23 a month. So as you can see, it's going to be fairly similar once you get to the CMS plans if you want to build a blog, for example. But if you just want a really basic site, Framer is going to be less expensive. So let's get into the actual product for each Webflow and Framer. So both are similar where you're going to have kind of this visual experience of building your website. I personally built more websites with Webflow because it's been around a little bit longer, but I also really enjoy designing in Framer. One of the differences is Framer is a lot more similar to Figma. So if you're used to building in Figma, designing in Figma, then Framer is going to feel really comfortable for you. Webflow is a little bit more like building a website as a web developer, not as a designer. So it's built a little bit more for a web developer, whereas Framer is built a little bit more as a designer. So depending on what background you're coming from, that might influence which platform you want to use. But both of them are really overall fairly easy to use. There's definitely a learning curve, and going from the basics to more advanced things is definitely going to take some time to learn how to use the platforms. Of course, there's also a learning curve of just, understanding design and being a good designer. So a lot of the times the final site is going to be a limitation of, your design ability as well. And I would also just recommend using the free trials of both Webflow and Framer, starting to kind of design and build in the platforms and kind of get a feel for which you enjoy building in better. One big advantage of Webflow is that you can export all of the code from your site that you design in Webflow, and if you want to host it elsewhere, you can do that. With Framer, you cannot do that. So that is something that is important to keep in mind and something that would make some people choose Webflow. Another feature that Webflow has is Ecommerce. So if that's something that's really important to you, you want to add Ecommerce onto your site, something that Framer doesn't currently have and Webflow does have. However, if you want to build just a pure e-commerce platform, you might want to look into a tool like Shopify instead of Webflow. But there are circumstances where you'd want to build e-commerce into Webflow, and that is something that they do have the ability for. The next category is templates. So if you want to start from a template in Framer or Webflow, which platform is going to be better for you? And in this situation, both are really strong. So there's a template marketplace on both Webflow and Framer. Webflow might have slightly more templates just because it's been around a little bit longer. But there are a lot of templates on both Webflow and Framer. And it's something that I would recommend checking out. And in a lot of cases, it might make sense to start from a template. even if you know how to build and design in Webflow and Framer, because it's just giving you a nice starting point to go off on. So hopefully that was a helpful overview of the similarities and differences between Webflow and Framer. Overall, I just recommend actually building a basic website with both Webflow and Framer in their free plans and kind of see which one you enjoy building with more. I don't think you can really go wrong. The other thing to keep in mind is, you know, Framer is going to be a little less expensive for those basic plans, which can make a difference if you don't need a really complicated website. But Webflow, on the other hand, you can export your code. They have more advanced functionality like Ecommerce because it's just a little bit more of a mature platform. So if you have any questions at all, please just leave a comment below. I'll do my best to answer any questions that you have. And check out nocode.mba if you want to learn more about building in Webflow and no-code. We're going to be adding Framer tutorials again soon. Right now we have a lot of Webflow tutorials on nocode.mba. And nocode.mba is actually built in Webflow. So if you go to nocode.mba, you'll be able to check out a website that's actually built in Webflow fully and kind of get a sense for what's possible. So again, I hope this was helpful. Be sure to subscribe to No Code MBA's YouTube channel for more free content in the future, and I'll see you in the next video.